guys. Welcome to my channel. My name is Adejuma Kazim Akiade. Based on series of questions I received from my last video titled Operational Procedures of Coiled Tubing Injector Head Traction System, I realized that most people don't really understand how each of the traction control devices interact with one another. Because of that, I have found it worthy to give another short presentation titled Coiled Tubing Injector Head Traction Circuit. This, I believed, will give more clear and deep understanding on how different coiled tubing traction control devices interact with one another. On this note, I urge all my viewers to please pay much attention to this presentation as I explain the circuit. Displayed on the screen is a coiled tubing injector head traction circuit. To my fellow colleagues in company where I currently work, this circuit is a case study of CT package 4. But irrespective of CT make, almost all traction circuits have similar features. Note, those lines in red are pressure lines from the hydraulic pump. Those in purple are pressure lines from the manual hydraulic hand pump. Those in black are suction to the pump. And finally, those in blue are return lines back to the tank. This presentation is sectioned into three different phases. Phase 1, explained traction control using injector traction pressure adjust. Phase 2, shall centered on traction control using emergency injector traction. And finally, phase 3, explained traction control using injector traction emergency hand pump. Starting from phase 1, that is traction control using injector traction pressure adjust. Traction system get hydraulic supply from the priority system pump. On the line is a check valve that prevents flow back of hydraulic to the pump. Injector pressure adjust get hydraulic supply from the pump to the pressure port of the valve. Check valve is also installed on the pressure port to prevent flow back. By the time you turn this adjust knob clockwise, hydraulic then flows out from the port arm to the off port of the emergency injector traction three-way pump valve. Since this valve is off, there will be communication between this off port and bottom port. Keeping this valve in off position implies you have completely isolated this other port, that is on port. Now, this flow of hydraulic comes out from this bottom port down to the pressure port of this traction bleed-off three-way pump valve. Since this valve is on pressure position, there will be communication between this pressure port and bottom port. This also implies that you have completely isolated the drain suction control two-way ball valve. This gauge helps to monitor the applied hydraulic pressure from the injector traction pressure adjust. Finally, each of these valves divert hydraulic flows to their respective traction cylinders on the coil-to-be injector head. That is, lower traction control valve divert hydraulic flows to the accumulator, then to the active end of the lower traction cylinder. Middle traction control valve divert hydraulic flows to the accumulator, then to the active end of the middle traction cylinder. And finally, upper traction control valve divert hydraulic flows to the accumulator, then to the active end of the upper traction cylinder. The applied pressure to each of the traction cylinders are being monitored with their respective pressure gauges. Each of these non-active ends of the traction cylinders are then routed back to the tank. This concludes the first phase of this presentation. Phase two of this presentation shall center on traction control using emergency injector traction three-way ball valve. Mostly, this valve is used in an emergency situation like runaway tubing. You arm this valve to supply the maximum preset pressure of the priority system to each of the traction cylinders, thereby bypassing the normal injector traction pressure adjust. This valve gets hydraulic supply directly from the priority system. When you on this valve, there will be communication between the on port and the button port. In that case, you have completely isolated the off port, thereby allowing flows of hydraulic coming from the on port to the bottom port of the valve. Now, this hydraulic flows through this line to the pressure port of the traction bleed-off valve. Since this valve is on pressure position, it then distributes hydraulic via the bottom port to each of the traction on and off control valve, while each of these valves diverts the hydraulic flows to their respective active ends of the traction cylinders on the injector head. Note, to use emergency injector traction for this design, you first on each of these valves so as to allow flows of hydraulic to their respective traction cylinders. But after applying the hydraulic pressure to the traction cylinders, endeavor to return each of these valves to on position. Also, take note, under normal working operation, this valve must also remain on off position. Finally, phase three of this presentation explained traction control using injector traction emergency and pump on and off two-way ball valve in conjunction with this manual hand pump. Mostly, this valve is used in an emergency condition like loss of hydraulic from the main injector traction pressure adjust or power pack failure. This system gets hydraulic supply from the stripper system circuit hydraulic reservoir mounted inside the control cabin. By the time you rock this pump up and down, hydraulic flows from this reservoir to the suction edge of this manual hand pump, then comes out from this outlet and discharges to this injector emergency hand pump on and off two-way bore valve. On the line is a check valve that prevents flow back, and also pressure relief valve that helps to divert excess pressure above the 3000 psi overall system pressure back to the tank. Keeping this valve on allows flows of hydraulic to each of the traction on and off control valve, while each of these valves diverts the hydraulic flows to their respective active ends of the traction cylinders on the injector head. Note, under normal operation, this valve must also remain on off position. Alternatively, instead of using three-way ball valve for emergency injector traction, we can as well use two-way ball valve as in the case of CT package 3. In that case, there will be slight changes in the connection. As you can see from the screen, we get hydraulic supply directly from the priority system to the on port of this two-way ball valve. Moment you on this valve, there will be flows of hydraulic via this other port to the multiple port check valve. Why this multiple port check valve distributes hydraulic to each of the traction cylinders directly without passing through each of these traction on and off control valve. That is, if in an emergency like runaway tubing and you switch on this valve, you get hydraulic supply to each of the traction cylinders directly, even if each of these valves are in off position. With this, we have come to the end of today's presentation. Until next time, when I shall come your way again with another interesting topic on stripper system, I remain your presenter, Adejumo Kazim Akiade. Thanks for watching. Bye. Hello guys, welcome to my channel. My name